trouble me because you bear the marks of Jesus in your body. Yeah. Trouble me not. I have suffered for God. Let no man trouble me. What have you been through? If you are bad, if you are bad, stay connected. This one needs to blow your mind. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12. Watch it, everybody. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will also deny us. If we suffer with the Lord, hey, I have been doing a lot for God. Tonight, this afternoon, I was reading the scripture. Something came to me. Paul wrote a letter to Timothy. Look at me, everybody. Paul wrote a letter to Timothy. He said, Timothy, my son, Timothy, I have fought the good fight of it. He said, Timothy, I have finished the course. And I have kept the faith. Watch this one. I have fought the good fight of faith. And I have kept the faith. Timothy, my poor, I have fought the good fight. Timothy, forget about the drama you see. That I say, eyes open, the eyes open. That is the drama. I have fought for it. That is the drama. So many of you want to prophesy. You want to get to my heart. You want to get into a mega heart in the prophetic. You look at the drama in church. But in my closet, I have fought. I have fought the discipline of the flesh. I have fought. And he said, I have finished the course. And this is the one that fixed me. He said, I have kept the faith. I have kept the faith. Many a times, troubles wanted me to give up the faith, but I kept it. Many a times, when things are not getting right, and everybody's looking at me, denying your God, and I didn't give away the faith, but I kept the faith. I lost my job, but I kept the faith. Now, I'm not fighting for the divorce, but I kept the faith. Timothy, I kept the faith. I didn't give away the faith. I've come on the way, but I've kept the feet. Turn to somebody and say, abide. That's abide. If we suffer with him, we will reign with him. But if we deny him, he also denies us. If we suffer with him, I have a lot to say. But let me give you this one. Then we go. Where is my Elijah? Come. I feel like a time to lose. I love both sides. Give a clap of love for my Elijah. Watch this one. To them that believe, watch this one. I want you to have the victorious. I am Elijah. This is Elijah, my son. Thank you. As he's following me, God said I should wait for him at Delta. Elijah said, I'll still follow you. Let's go. And the sons of the prophets, they did everything to distract Elijah. Do you know that the Lord will take away your master? And Elijah said, I know, hold your peace. Elijah got to Delta. He said, God said I should go to Bethel. He said, wait for me here. He said, as so long as God needed to deliver you, I'll follow you. Keep following. Elijah is following Elijah. You are following Elijah. They go to Bethel. But the God said, I should wait for him at Jordan. So he's staying here and wait for me. He said, my father, as the Lord liveth and the soul liveth, I will still follow you. And Elijah said, okay. I'm going to Jordan, I'm going to Jericho. I'm going to go to Jericho, Jordan. I say, okay, you're missing some for Jordan or Jericho. So you stay here. He said, so long as your soul liveth and God liveth, I will still follow you. And they went. And now when they got to Jericho, Elijah looked at Elisha and said, what do you want from me? Ask me what you want from me that I may give it to you. Elijah never said that until he saw relentlessness, perseverance, and longevity. He started abiding in him. Following him. Yes. And the Bible said, to touch this one. The Bible said, to them that believe it, he gave them power to become. You are believing all this one, I'm giving you the power to ask. It is so deep. To them that believe in him, he gave them power to become the sons. But I'm giving you the power to ask what you want to become. So what do you want from me? Elijah said, I need a double mantle. And do you know the double mantle? The double mantle is the match fruit. I need a double mantle from you. Now, listen to me. God will not have a long term with a short term person. God will not have a long term relationship with a just short-term person. If Elijah had quit at Bethel, he wouldn't have given the opportunity to ask. Some of you, God is waiting on you. God is working on your patience. God is working on your patience. God is working on your humility. God is working on your character, your pride. So when you are humble and empty, then God can fill you, because God does not fill the filled, he only fills the empty. If only you are bad. If you are bad in me, now come. By the time you have followed me from Gilgal, Jordan, Bethel to Jericho, the sons of the prophets were distracting you, but you never gave heed to them. And you still abide with me. Some of your strengths wanted to keep you out of church. Some of your situations wanted to slow you down. But you still follow God and abide. Yeah. And Elijah is looking at Elijah. He said, by the time I give you my mantle, you wouldn't even want my mantle. You rather want me. Come. You rather want to be with me. Because now, you are not only looking for my mantle, but because you have been with me for too long, you have come too far to miss me. And so now you have placed value on the man and not the mantle. So if you can play value of the plan and not the fruit, the man will come back to you. Elijah, come. You can only have my double mantle. I'm about to pray for you. Something will come on you. You can only have my double mantle. Not because you wanted it. Not because you deserve it. But I've checked you over time. I have checked your consequences, your consistency, and I've checked how persevere you are. You are relentless. You don't give up. You don't pick too much. You don't pick too early. Elijah, before I go, the mountain is not for me, but the person of Elijah will go, but the mountain of Elijah will rest for you. Receive this double portion. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. You have come too far. If only you are mine. If only you are mine, God will give you something. And maybe it's only Christ alone. Ha! I didn't want film. I remember last year, I said it here. I wheeled my mother into the theater room. You cannot take that one. I saw that picture. I look at it and I'm crying. I wheel my mother into the theater room for my mother to be dissected. You could tell me how anointed God is really using me. My body is sitting on a critical case. And your remedy. Watch my videos on YouTube. I have done so much for God and I needed God for my mother. And there was no results. I went home and I took money, 85 million for the preach. And as I was counting the money, I said, Father, I'm not going to draw away this money for a doctor. And I acted to confront her, look for the wheel, and I wheeled my mother to the theater. And whilst we were going, my mother was singing him. And he said, Prophet, are you watching me to be dissected? Are you watching me to be cut over? Are you watching me to be cut open? I looked at my mother and I was crying. I remember it was Wednesday. They told me to bring my brother to our mission Sunday. And guess what? That Sunday I was ministering. But my brother took us to and I'm saying, receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive the miracle. And people were receiving. Like in deep side of my inside, I was weeping. I was crying. When I finished the church, when I finished ministry, Monday I went to Kofolachi, Tuesday I went to Kofolachi, and they gave me that I should come with 85 million for operation. That was there for the operation. I counted 85 million. I gave it to a doctor. The doctor looked at me and said, prophet, this one here, I have to cut your mother. This one is not great, I have to cut. And I prayed that God intervened. I wheeled my mother to the theater, and my mother was cut for me. If it were you. And that week, I was still ministering. I was still doing revival. I was preaching and prophesying. And I looked at that situation. And I said, God, where are you? But you see, catch this one. Bishops, it is one thing to preach what you have not experienced. And it is one thing to preach what you have experienced. If you preach what you have not experienced, you inspire. But if you preach what you have experienced, you empower. Amen. So now, when I start to empower somebody with my message, I am not preaching as someone I have not experienced. I am preaching as a witness. And I'm witnessing to every fact that nothing can separate me from the love of God. If he chooses to bless me, fine. But if he doesn't bless me, I'm okay. Now listen to four major answers God gives to everybody, but we don't want the answers. These are the four mental answers God gives to everybody after you have prayed. Watch my mouth. I'm going to mine, but you will catch it. If you pray, Father, I want this. The first answer, God said, no. Father, I want this. The second one, God said, slow. The third one, Father, I want this thing. I want this job. I want it so much. God said, grow. And the final one, Father, indeed, I want this job. God said, go. So the first one is no. Your time is not now. Second one, slow. Got you in hand. Third one, grow. You have not matured. Fourth one, go. You are set to go. These are the answers that God gave us. And I end my message, Acts chapter 4, verse 13. Abide in me. Abide. Give somebody a high five, shout abide. Check. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled and they took knowledge of them that they have been with. They have been with. Somebody say abide. Peter, I'm not going to school. I said, you're waiting on my school for great reading. Bible says, before John said, they knew they have abided with Jesus. If you abide with him, the impossibility becomes possible. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow. Under the shadow. And then I'm sure say again, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So what's not a dreadful asset, not a real power. A very castle, but a very castle that the shame of the tree also covers you. We will be our own set and even in Asia. Until the other women say, I will not go to the good tissue. Now, was I shall you go to the good tissue? Or it's been some of the to the princess of Solomon to bed at the back. None of the chicken will never move out because even when the mother is over, they still feel the shadow. They still feel the presence of God. This will be your testimony. And this will be your grace. God will be with you as you abide in him. You will never fail. You will never fall. You will never falter. What is coming between you and God? If you can still abide, you see your match fruit. Elisha abide for too long and he had a double portion. I pray for you. In spite of your problems, your conditions, your circumstances, your difficulties and your hard times, if you can still abide, God will glorify you. God bless you.